بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. My brother, it probably is a brother, I guess. It might just be a sister as well. You know, firstly, I really appreciate the fact that you brought it up because I believe a lot of Muslims are affected by this quietly, silently. I was reading statistics and I found that some of the Muslim countries have the highest viewing of pornography. Firstly, you need to make tawbah, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you and constantly repeat that, and you need to make a lot of changes in your life. There are courses. I have a friend, a mutual friend of mine in Sheikh Muhammad. His name is Brother Wa'il Ibrahim. Maybe you can search him, Serving Islam team in Hong Kong. You can even send him an email. He has specialized in this field and he does a lot of courses to rehabilitate. In fact, I have seen, because he has sent me some of the material, really beneficial, where he asks you so many questions in order to try and help you. And, you know, part of what is said, obviously, based on Islam, you need to change the setting of your day. You need to increase your good deeds a lot. Because when you increase your good deeds, automatically your bad deeds begin to decrease. It's like a seesaw. So if your salah is on time and your wudu is always intact and you read Quran often and you have the listening of good Islamic lectures and you are in good company and your PC or whatever you're watching this thing from is actually in public, and perhaps if you're a female and you're a sister and you're a male, you might have a brother of yours, a sibling, a brother of yours or a sister of yours, the same gender, sleeping in the same room. And perhaps you would be a little bit more open with what you are doing. And maybe if you have a problem of the internet, cut it off. There are so many different ways of doing things, but you have to be serious. And you have to want to help yourself. You have to make sure that you are prepared to make drastic changes for the sake of Allah. In a nutshell, I'd like to encourage you, just in a few moments that I have, to develop your taqwa levels by increasing the goodness and the good deeds that you're doing a lot. You know, get into sunnah and nafil salah as well. Get into adhkar, you know, these subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar after salah. Sit, declare the greatness of Allah, ask Him forgiveness. Also have good company. Make sure that you have good company. Engage yourself in something constructive so you don't have as much time for this, for something destructive. And on top of that, you will probably need further help, and I wouldn't be able to in a few moments go into every detail, but I think I've touched on what is necessary. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us goodness. What I believe is make a lot of dua to Allah to keep you away from haram. Allahumma habib ilayna al-iman wa zayyinhu fi qulubina wa karrih ilayna al-kufra wal-fusuqa wal-isyana waj'alna min al-rashidin. O Allah, we ask you to make beloved to us iman, belief, good deeds and so on. And we ask you to make detested and hated to us disbelief and you know, disobedience and sin and so on. And make us from amongst the righteous. It's a dua that's mentioned in the Quran. And we need to ask Allah. And please, when you make a dua, be serious about it. Do not just make a dua to say, okay, I made dua, but I'm still on pornography. I made dua, but I'm still hooked onto masturbation. I've made dua, but no. Make a dua with the intention of quitting and quit it. And if shaitan entraps you once in a blue moon, perhaps, may Allah not do that to us, but if you're entrapped, immediately get off it and immediately ask Allah's forgiveness. And tell yourself, this might be the last moment before I breathe. The end. Imagine if there's an earthquake. Imagine if there's a fire. Imagine if suddenly you have a heart attack. I want to give you one true story. Wallahi, it's a true story. May Allah never do this to us. There was a family, and they were very, very religious. And the father was the head of the family. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from shaitan. And the children were all religious based on the father. And when he died in the company of two prostitutes with some alcohol bottles in his hands at a destination that was unacceptable. His children refused to attend his own burial. What happened? It was shaitan. Shaitan who gave him a bad ending. We still make dua that Allah give him Jannah and forgive him. And Allah look at his good deeds. But who from amongst you would like to die whilst watching pornography and you have a heart attack? (Laughs)